happy Aloha Friday. Notice the Jamaica shirt, gotta wear it proud. Today I'm gonna be showing you guys a hair video, how to get a slick back comb over combo. And it's gonna take about 10 minutes to do, but it lasts all day long. It's super easy. If you have any questions or comments, go ahead and put those down below. If you like this video, please like it, give it a subscribe. I'm gonna try to get as many videos out as I can in the near future. And I'm a little bit scraggly. I definitely need to get a haircut. So I'll have another video coming out of how to do the same thing once I get that haircut. It's basically the same, just a little bit of tweaks. So yeah, now onto the video. We've got your hair dryer, we got a comb, and we have your styling fiber or pomade. Usually I go with Fix Your Lid. It's a lot cheaper than the American Crew stuff. You just have to apply a little bit more, but it comes in a bigger container and it lasts longer and doesn't go in as hard, easier to get out. So usually I do this right after I get out of the shower, so my hair is still a little wet. Then I'll go ahead and I'll blow dry my hair and then I'll go from there. So we're done with that. Right now my hair's still a little wet, just so that it's easier to get the product into it. But at this point I'll take my comb, and I have a part, so I kind of just comb everything over, get it out of the way where I want it. I'm lucky enough to have two little calyx right here and right here, so it's a pain for me to work with. So I've had to figure out what I like to do. Gel I'm not a huge fan of, just because I don't like that greasy texture to it, plus it doesn't hold as well. So I go with the Fix Your Lid. Styling fiber, open it up, it looks like this. I've already used about half of it. And then I start right here along my part. So use my finger, grab a little bit. I mean, you're gonna keep grabbing more as you go on. But I'll pull my hair over and then I'll just work it right there against the part. Make sure I keep everything where it needs to be. Once I get that done, I'll get the underside. And you don't need a whole lot here just because your hair's shorter. You don't need to hold it down as much. Okay, so I got the product in there, and now comes the front. So I grabbed a little bit more, and then I work my way over from the part over as I go. And really you're kind of just pinching your hair, getting that product in there. Then you can run your fingers through your hair just so that it gets underneath as well, so it's not just under the surface, or on the surface. If it's on the surface, you're not going to get as good of a hold throughout the day. Then, now that I've gotten that part, I'll go over to the left side where my hair is a lot longer. It usually comes right down to the side, about to my ear. So I'll get the front, and then I'll get the back side right here. And so this I'll kind of just press down on to the side of my head. That way it holds right there as I need it. So now I got product in there for the most part. Now we start combing. So I'll comb down the sides first, make sure the part's looking good. And you'll see that it's still pretty white. You want to get as much of that out as you can, but throughout the day it's going to fade. Now on the part, going to just comb it over to the side. And it's not gonna look like old man comb over when you're done. We'll mess it up as we go. So for my hair personally, when I'm combing it out in front, as long as it's going basically straight out, I'll get a good hold on it. Right now, it looks like I'm gonna need a little bit more product in there.
And remember, everybody's hair is different. You might have to do it a little bit differently depending on the kind of hair you have. I have pretty thick hair, and it's pretty straight except for my calyx, so this works for me. So now, there we go. Now it's sticking out. And once it's sticking out in front, then I just use my hand and I comb it back. And when I use my hand, it gives it pretty even. It doesn't look like it's been combed over. And then you basically just go until you have it as flat as you want. And then sometimes I'll usually have a couple of hair pulled down in the front just to make it look a little bit messier. Personally, that's the kind of style that I like. Sorry, I'm like getting pretty close to the camera. But yeah, just pull down a couple in front and it'll dry. Everything will dry for like the next hour or so. But as long as you're not doing anything too crazy, too active, like if you're just going to work like I'm doing, it'll hold throughout the rest of the day. And so yesterday it was a little bit better than it is today, but when you're working with your hair, you just can't really fight it. If you're fighting it, then it's not really gonna work out the way you want it to. So just go with whatever your hair wants to do. And then at the end, we got the side, and then going through, looks like that. Now for my beard, I use stuff from the Uncut Beard Company or the Dollar Beard Club. I have my balm, I have growth oil, and I have the sandalwood oil. And on all of these, you want to use just like a dime size amount for the oils. I usually do my growth oil first. And right here for me never grows in, so I really focus right there, and it's actually been working. I'm just telling you guys what I use, what I find that works for me. So I got that one done. I don't like having my hands all oily and greasy, so I always wipe them off after I use everything. Then I'll use the sandalwood one. Basically get where you have facial hair. And then the last one I'll use is the balm. Now the balm is kind of like the styling primer or the pomade. It comes out like that. I usually get like about that much for how much of a beard I have, and then I'll just cut it in half, rub it between my fingers, and I'll start from the back. Work my way to the middle and then pinch on your mustache so that you get those annoying hairs out of the way of your lips. It doesn't feel weird when it dries, it doesn't hold everything like really stiff, but it definitely works. So I highly recommend it. I love using this stuff. And that's it. So this is how you get kind of a slick back comb over mix.
Well, it's been about 10 minutes and the product's already dried. And as you can see, like it still moves pretty freely. Like with this little strand of hair right there, I like it because it looks a little bit messier. I don't really like a huge, neat look, but this is gonna be good enough to last for the rest of the day. So yeah, I'm telling you guys, it works.